Now, in the next few modules, we discuss different issues related to family policy. So, in this module, we are going to discuss how many children. So, how many children there should be in the family. This is one important aspect of the family policy. Initially, historically, all states or governments were pro-natalist, meaning thereby that they supported more children. The more, the better. And it was good for them that people were having more children because there were epidemics, people were dying because of poverty, the average age was low, and they didn't have to provide any health benefits or education benefits or any social welfare to the people. So it didn't cost much to them if more children were being born. More children meaning meant also that there was cheap labor, which was good for the economy. There was no democracy, so it didn't matter if people died or lived in extreme poverty. So in this case, before, if you look at the policies of 18th century or before, most states were not concerned about limiting fertility rates. In fact, they wanted more children or more people to fight their wars. And religions, almost all religions, were also against family planning or contraception. So that helped. So both the state policy and the religious policy were aligned in getting more and more children. Change started in the second half of the 19th century, that it was discovered that resources are, or it was the Malthus who popularized the idea that resources are limited, but the population is increasing, and a time will come when the resources will dry up and will be nothing for the mankind to live on. But still, most advanced countries didn't explicitly call for less number of children in the 20th century. Reason was that the demographic change in these countries were already happening. Women were being educated, women were getting jobs, there were health improvements. So the fertility rate was already going down. So government didn't need to do anything to reduce the fertility rate. The case for developing countries was different. So after World War II, as the institutions like World Bank came into existence, which supported the development in poor countries, or even the advanced countries started to support the poor countries in development, the link between low fertility rate and development was established. And World Bank and USAID and other countries gave aid, money, technical assistance to poor countries for family planning. This led to backlash by religious groups. One of the most interesting cases is of China, which came up with a drastic and very cruel decision of one child policy in the late 70s. So this policy was applied universally and very strictly in urban areas. There were some very few exceptions related to ethnic minorities or families whose firstborn was a special child, but rest of them had to accept that they can only have one child. And sometimes even forced abortion and sterilizations were carried by the government to implement this policy. It was decided in 2016 that there will be some relaxation and some of the groups can have two children. But that was it. Most of the other developing countries did not have strict policies. They tried to reduce their fertility rate. There were campaigns. There were incentives. Some were successful. Other were not. And then, of course, as the female education was increasing, the fertility rate went down even without these campaigns. Iran's experience was extraordinary in the sense that they had an extra, a miraculous decrease in fertility rate from 1990 to 2000. In 10 years, it reduced the fertility rate from 6.5 to around 2, which is the replacement rate. What happened was that under the monarchs, Pahlavi monarchs, the fertility rate was going down. As you can see, that it went from 7 to 6 in from 1960 to 1970. But then there was an Islamic revolution, and it led to Imam Khomeini said that there should be more Iranians and more Muslims. So there you see that fertility rate actually increased after 75, 76 till 1985. But then after the Imam Khomeini's death, it was realized that more population is going to be a disaster for Iran. So the Iranian regime, which is ruled by ulama and Islamic theologians, they came up with this policy that they are going to go for family planning. So they started, they even have state produced condom factories and others, and they drastically reduce their fertility rate from 6.5 to 2 in a matter of 10 years. So this is Pakistan, as you see, has a very gradual decline, and we are working on it. So this is how different countries have dealt with how many children there should be in a family.